Hello, this is Sean Shaw with It's a Mouthful, and I'm excited to bring you my third segment of Dinner and Dialogue. I'm excited particularly because I've been following this lady's music for a while, and I've been trying to reach her on Twitter. Yes, she is social, and she responds to her customers, not customers, her audience and her fans and all those people.
You think about the dinner, right?
Yeah.
You're not going to be in the restaurant. No,
Exactly. But I'm glad to say that I'm sitting across from Avery Sunshine. Thank you so much
for
coming by and spending some time with me. And, you know, this is new for me. So when I say I'm excited to be speaking with you,
yes.
I mean that sincerely.
Oh, I'm going to say, well, your teeth are so white.
Oh, so are yours.
You know, I'm not that white.
It's just because I'm so dark.
No. Beautiful. I'm sorry. See, I'm just out of the blue. I'm sorry.
Oh, that's okay. It's okay. But again, you know, you're just so a ball of energy and just such a source of light and your music. It just comes through your music. And I was just listening to the CD the other day. You know, I listen to it all the time, and it's amazing. If anybody, if you haven't picked up Avery Sunshine CD, you have to get it. It's awesome. It's amazing. And it ain't all in my head. It's just not all in my head either. Don't you trust me. It's not.
I appreciate that.
It's great. It's great.
I appreciate it.
And I love how you are so engaging with your audience. You know, I went to the concert with you and Rahsaan Patterson, which was amazing. That was like a revival. Okay. Like a revival.
I love Rahsaan.
Yeah, yeah.
It's amazing to do shows with people who, you know, I remember going to Tower Records when it was at Lenox Mall.
Yeah.
Now, how long you been in Atlanta?
Oh, I've been in Atlanta since 91.
So do you remember there was a Tower Records?
Oh, yeah.
I would go there and buy all kinds of CDs.
Yeah.
And I remember they used to have a thing where they had the CDs and you could see, like you could hear the new artists coming out.
Right.
Kind of sitting out.
Those booths.
Yes, booth like.
Yes.
And he was on there.
Oh,
and I remember hearing that, and I feel like it changed the way I listen to music.
Right.
It's like, this is amazing.
Right.
I had no idea that I would be sharing this stage with him. I just never.
Yeah, because, you know, along with Rahsaan Patterson, your music is therapy, you know, and I know because you speak a lot through your music about, you know, experiences and you know, life and things of that nature.
That album helped me through my divorce.
Oh, okay.
It did,
okay.
You know, that writing that album really helped me deal with it.
Right.
Unfortunately, yes, I was one of those people. I did not go to a therapist. I should have. I'm going to now. No, but it did help me being able to talk about it and get it out.
Right.
It did help me. So y'all, people hear that record, they're hearing a transition and transformation.
Okay. Okay.
They really are.
That's good. That's good. Yeah. So being that you had gone through that, and I know you're probably on the other side of that.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm looking forward to the next project. And I understand that you're working on that now.
Right now, we have some amazing, hopefully, messages that people really speak to people, like the first record.
Right.
There's one song that's really dear. I guess they're all dear to me, but this one's really dear to me. I wanted to write something about acceptance.
Yeah.
And I don't care what it is you do, as long as you're a good person.
Right.
You go do your thing, I'm going to do my thing, but I promise you we're going to see each other on the other side.
Right, absolutely.
So the song is called See You When I Get There.
Oh, nice.
So you go your way, I go mine.
Yeah.
It'll be all right.
We all have different paths.
Y'all have different paths.
Yeah.
And nobody's way is right for everybody else.
Right.
It'll be right for you.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right,
so
absolutely.
I wanted to celebrate our differences and encourage us to be accepting.
Yes.
You know, I'm just tired of all of that.
Just a lot of it, right?
Yeah. And I feel like you've become so cynical and judgmental.
Right.
Being able, everybody's got a voice now because of Facebook and Twitter. Everybody got something to say.
Right.
It's not always positive, you know. We don't find, it seems like it's, you know, ironically though, I find that, you know, if I'm having a special day, one of those off days, I'll go to Instagram or something, and somebody has put something on there that's so positive and wonderful. That's the other side of it.
Right, 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 absolutely.
I'm glad about that.
That's good. You know, it's just like a democracy of life, if you will.
Yeah.
And speaking of which, I know that you performed at the Democratic Convention in Denver.
Yes.
You know, how was that? I know that was that a different stage for you? It was
absolutely
a different experience for you, right?
And my album wasn't out then. I was just getting going, and to have the opportunity to be a part of history in that way.
Right.
Even say I'm in the same city as the man who might be the president, black man.
Right, right.
It was definitely a highlight of my career.
Okay.
Definitely.
Yeah.
I haven't met him yet.
Right, right. But you know,
definitely.
You know, we could change that because you know it's a mouthful. It's about to blow up. And Dinner and Dialogue is going worldwide.
This is what I'm talking.
Yeah.
Let's speak it to.
Yeah, you have to speak into existence,
absolutely,
right?
Absolutely.
So yeah. I mean, I know that you've done a lot of music, and you know you're very talented. You have your own pianist, you're a songstress, you're a therapist. I mean,
I like that.
Yes, very much so. So, do you have anybody that you would love to just collaborate with? You know, as you tell your story, as you put songs together, as you think through things, you're like, man, that needs a baritone on the other side of this song.
I know that's
You know, I don't know.
I mean, I always say this, but there are two people that I really would love to collaborate with. One of them is R. Kelly.
Okay. All right.
I love R. Kelly.
I would have never guessed that, but that's good.
I love R. Kelly. He's a musician. I think
he's brilliant.
Man.
He's a genius.
And he allows himself. Now the pendulum does swing the other way as well. But I think that might be the cost. But you know what I mean? The price for that depth.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
I love him. And Michael McDonald.
Yes. Oh yeah, I love that. I've always loved his music. Yeah.
Oh my God, the Doobie Brothers?
Yeah.
And just sit down, my dream is that I'd be able to sit down, you know, I'd be on a road to be on the roads on the other side. We'd be facing each other, thousands of people. I don't know what we would sing.
Okay.
I'm gonna have to sit there and look at him.
Kind of like Patti LaBelle and his collaboration.
Something like that, except I'm on the keys.
Okay.
But like I said, I might be so stunned up. I should be stiff, you know what I mean?
Right. So, you know, I know that you like I said, you sing, you're a pianist.
Yeah.
If you had to choose, and I know both of those are a passion of yours, if one of them could not do one of those ever again, which one would you choose to do for the remainder of your career?
Same.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you can get somebody to play for you.
Yeah, that's true. But when you play, you know, it's a different experience. It's a whole experience.
Yeah, definitely. So I don't want either. Lord, we don't want either of these to go.
No,
but,
not at all.
Yeah, I never thought of myself as that. You know, I'd have people tell me, you know, so I don't consider myself, you know, the greatest pianist, you know.
Right.
But I've had people
good.
Say,
you bad.
Play.
No. Yeah. Let's be clear on that.
I
don't say you should. Sorry, you said one. I love it. But yeah, you bad girl on those keys.
But Dana and I have a good friend, Daniel Moore, who is an amazing musician, somebody you need to.
Okay.
I mean, he's actually one of the producers of Sunday's Best.
Oh, yeah. I love that.
Played
show.
With some of everybody, played with Neo, whatever. But he's on our pack, the first record, and on this one. And he said, when you play and sing, something happens.
Yes.
And I listened to him. Dana said the same thing. Dana always says that you don't hear it when I say it. Somebody else got to say it. I do hear it when he says it, though.
Yeah.
But, I'm owning that, and I'm accepting it. Like, fine, that's what it is. I will play and sing.
Okay.
Like, I'd rather hear you play. But, okay, fine, I'll play and sing.
Yeah, that kind of all goes together.
I guess it does. So.
Yeah.
As open as I can be.
Yeah.
Well, you know, when it happens, I just take advantage of the opportunity.
Yes, absolutely.
And I feel like my path has found me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, steps have been ordered.
They clearly, because I can tell, I don't know how I got here. Putting, you know, at the moment that I knew want to be a musician, I think everything just started lining up.
Yeah.
It did. People just, doors, even Dana, you know, our relationship, it just kind of, you know, he knew what to do, the business. I was like, dude, I just want to sing. I don't, it's like, well, no, this is what you need to do. And, you know.
It's amazing how those moments of serendipity.
Oh, absolutely.
Infiltrates our lives.
Yes.
Those moments of opportunity.
And those are the times you really, for me, yes, those are the times I really see God's work.
Yes.
The you know, the miracle of the serendipitous moments. You know what I mean? It's like, wow, there's got to be a God.
Right.
How can you not believe?
That's true.
Now,
we're not trying to have church.
We're not trying to convert nobody. But whatever you call God, I mean, it was the truth. I mean, it could be anything, but to acknowledge it, I mean, really, whatever the religion is, but to not acknowledge it, that there is a larger, bigger than you being that exists.
Yes.
You know, for me, I know.
I know that your roots are in church.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're from Chester,
Chester, Pennsylvania.
And you were part of that mass choir.
Yeah, the Wilmington Chester Mass Choir.
Yes.
You know, so. Stellar award winning Wilmington Chester Mass Choir.
Absolutely. Yes. Absolutely. Yeah. So, do you ever get feedback from your previous, you know, brethren and sisters back there to say, you know, wow, kind of changed the way that she...
No, because those same people are just like me.
Okay.
They just shouting and playing a tambourine on Sunday morning.
Right.
But they're doing the same. They are just like me. They hurt. They mess up. Mm-hmm. They got baby daddies.
Yeah.
They might have two or three baby daddies.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Are, you know, and that's what I really want to celebrate, that you can have a relationship with God and still live a life.
Right, absolutely.
You know, you don't have to be pious. I'm in a box and I'm just this pious person. Oh, I never drink and I never, never, ever. Oh, what? Get out of here.
Yes.
That's a lie. You know what I mean?
A lot of people get confused. You know,
yes.
If I was to be a Christian or a follower of a certain religion,
yes.
You have to act in a certain way.
And being honest about it. You don't have to keep it to yourself.
Right.
That's really where we can see the work of God, the handiwork of God, so to speak. When you can say, I was here.
Right.
Look where I am now. No, people have no reference. They don't know. You know, they just think you wake up and you got makeup on. That ain't the truth.
Right.
I got pimples. You know what I mean? Thank you. But you know what I mean?
Absolutely. I know that the premise of doing dialogue is to talk a little bit about, you know, A-listers here in Atlanta, talking about food, fortune.
Am I an A-lister?
You are A-lister.
A-lister because of Atlanta lister, like A-lister.
A-lister.
I like that.
I love it. So I want to put together something, as I have been doing a blog for a number of years.
Awesome.
I want to understand what my next path would be.
Yeah.
Speaking of ordered steps.
Uh-huh.
And I thought that this would be a nice transition to be more inclusive with the community
Absolutely.
As a whole, and include A-listers like yourself, celebrities, and talk to them a little bit about, and get people to understand a little bit, you know, about the artists, and feel a little bit more, you know, engaged
Absolutely.
With them, understand where they're coming from, but also to give some of the great restaurants that are here in Atlanta opportunity to showcase their great work and great cuisine and create signature traditions on behalf of the artists, and then be on their menu for a period of time and have
brilliant.
Some proceeds go towards a charity your choice.
Yes.
And unless you tell the people, the charity that you've chosen.
Yeah, I've chosen Maximum Impact Love. And it is a it's a charity that I actually found the charity at the bank. I was at the bank working. They said there's a charity. But the bank, I asked about because I didn't want to do the regular United Way, or not that that's bad or anything. I wanted something in the community that I could be a part of, really, and make a difference. And Maximum Impact has been in existence, I think, about now for 15 years. And they go into the community, give haircuts, food, whatever it is. Every so often, like this Saturday they have, and I brought it so I could tell you about it. This Saturday, they have an event going on from 11 to 4. Bring the children out. Let's get haircuts. Let's whatever they need for the summer. Let's whatever we can do to support that way. Let's have hot dogs and ice cream and enjoy each other's company as well as meet some needs as well.
Yeah.
And that's just one of the charities that I'm going to be involved with, and I'm thinking about starting my own charity.
Okay.
I am, and I'm looking forward to that.
Kinda going through. I had no reason to trip out on you. Yes, I was acting like a fool, and I'm sorry. And all I can say is just that ugly
heart. I know that you love food.
Can't you tell?
Oh, but I love it too, so you know.
No, see, but you got a different metabolism. You got, he got that different metabolism.
So yeah, I do like.
You got that one I wish I had.
Yeah.
Shoot. And anyway, but I do. I have to watch it because I am a foodie, and my partner Dana is a foodie.
Okay.
His metabolism is like yours, so he can just eat, and I just gotta look. You know what I mean? We had the best time. We went to, when we were in Switzerland.
Okay.
I mean, and I, believe it or not, I lost weight.
In the portions are smaller.
The portions are smaller. Exactly. The food is cleaner.
Yeah.
You know, I was like, Lord, I need to move this. I can be sexy and eat what I want. Yeah. What? I'm Swiss. Yeah. Thank you very much. How about
that's
that?
Awesome.
Shoot.
Swish sunshine.
The swish sunshine. I like the swish sunshine. I can't even say it, but that's it. Jesus.
Now, did you cook? I mean, you know,
I used to cook. I used to cook, you know, when I was married. Mm-hmm. And when I got divorced, my mother, my mom moved here, both my parents, and they both cook. And I mean, they cook. So I haven't had to cook. You know, they'll have me do something, you know, for the holiday. Make some macaroni and cheese. And that's it. Don't make nothing else. You know, but I cook out of necessity. I cook so we don't die.
Okay.
But my love is not there. I mean, if I could do it, I would, you know.
The answer. I know when you follow your passion, you just
listen, it's going to be right. If I do make a ham sandwich, it's going to be the sickest ham sandwich you ever had. But I found that my love is not there, you know.
Okay.
But I like to eat.
Do you have a favorite food?
Yes. It's terrible. I love pasta.
Pasta.
I love.
Yes.
And the cream sauces.
Okay. And see, we're going to have something that's going to be inspired by your love of music as well as food.
Nice.
So,
when
I get
the
nostalgia.
Great.
Dough pizza.
Yes.
I didn't think I mentioned that. We're here at Dough Restaurant.
Dough.
Which is owned by Chris Ruffin and his wife Natasha.
Yes.
And it's a wonderful place to be.
Awesome.
It's at 955 Marriott. West Marriott Street.
That's it.
Over here in King Cloud. And we got a lovely view of the city of Atlanta.
It is. Hopefully we're going to do our CD release here. The place is awesome. And they have this killer red velvet cake. Have you had it? Dough.
Yeah.
As in do re mi fa sol la ti. Dough.
Absolutely.
Yes.
She's giving a plug. Yeah.
That's right.
It's amazing.
It is amazing.
Yeah.
And they said in the second year, it's been successful. It's amazing.
Yes, and I think last year they were one of the, if not the top restaurant in Atlanta.
I believe it.
I mean, I was like, wow.
I believe it.
Christian is saying, come on, Christian.
Yeah.
Come on with it.
That's
so,
right.
I know that you've been very busy on the road.
Yeah.
Is there any place that you would just love to perform? You know,
yes. Australia.
Okay.
Oh God! And then whatever that I cannot remember the name of that. The infamous.
The amphitheater.
Exactly.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I would love to do that.
Yeah.
You know, there are countless other places.
Yes.
That's just the first place that comes to mind.
Right.
But here in the States, there are places I want to play. You know.
Right.
You know, Carnegie Hall would be amazing.
Mm.
With a symphony. Oh my God. And a Burzendorfer piano. What? And I went, what?
Yeah, that would be
amazing.
I can only imagine that. So what are your thoughts behind, just real quick, what are your thoughts behind the way music is today? You know, because, you know, we don't have the Patty Austins and the Gerald Albrights.
Yeah.
You know,
they're there. We have to search for them.
Yes. Yeah.
That's not what's popular anymore.
Right.
And unfortunately, because there's no balance, I think we're getting lost. Because I don't mind, the new stuff I think is great.
Yeah.
But it would be good if we had some balance.
Yes.
So I don't listen to the radio as much anymore. My kids and I, Dana turned us on to, we listen to comedy radio. 92.3.
I love it.
Oh,
but again, thank you again to Savory Sunshine
for
taking time out to speak with us again. You can follow me on Twitter, I'm on Instagram, I'm on LinkedIn, and you can follow me on my blog at www.itsamouthful.blogspot.com.
Nice.
And you can follow Avery Sunshine.
Yes, at Avery Sunshine on Twitter, at I Am Avery Sunshine on Facebook, and Avery Sunshine on Instagram. I'm not on LinkedIn. I can't get into LinkedIn. I just can't. My mind is not really.
Yeah, that's a whole different.
That's a whole different thing.
Yeah.
You see, because you're corporate.
Yeah, I
got time for this.
I'm cool.
They're trying to get me in Pinterest. I can't.
No, I can't.
That's too much. I get them three. I can manage that.
Yeah.
MySpace. I don't know. I ain't even been on that page.
Yeah,
I don't know what space
that
is. Oh, people. So people don't do that anymore.
Yeah.
I didn't think so.
Okay.
It's so wonderful.